Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market preparation video for February 24th, 2020. My goodness, we had quite a week last week, and this week, if you've woken up this morning, you are probably a little disturbed at what you are seeing today. Let's take a moment to take a breath, let's settle in, and let's get ready for the morning market prep video. So this morning, we kind of flipped over from these warning signs here that were beginning to show themselves, the bears getting more aggressive heading into the weekend, and that kind of flipped over to pure panic as the outbreak is really starting to cause some issues economically, and the fears of what could potentially occur are growing dramatically. We have an outbreak spreading quickly across Europe. Major concerns in South Korea as those outbreak numbers jump up over 600 folks. Iran is seeing a significant increase in cases. As a matter of fact, the virus has spread to more than 22 countries, and we're starting to feel some of those impacts, or at least the market is starting to see those impacts rather than ignore those impacts as the weekend went on and just continued to grow. So this morning we are looking at an ugly gap down. At one point during the night, we were down more than 800 points in the Dow. And as you can see, the Dow gapping down substantially here this morning. This is where it's indicated to open at the moment. And certainly going to be a painful morning for a lot of folks. Now, I know I have been, it was almost annoying to a lot of folks. I got the emails about me continuing to warn to be careful, to not overtrade, to not chase this market. And you can see, as I've mentioned several times, that kind of thing typically ends badly. I had no idea that it would end this badly, or that this is even the end of what the virus impacts may bring to the market. So we're going to just have to watch this really closely and be careful not to get overly emotionally charged here. It's going to be very, very easy for people to make very poor trading decisions in full-on panic mode as this unfolds. So let's be really careful. Let's think about what we have going here in the chart. Well, first off, with this big sell-off, it's opened up this massive gap above. So one of the things that we're likely going to see and likely going to hear, and I'm going to ask you to pretty much ignore this, at least for now, and that is, oh my gosh, they're overcorrecting. Buy the dip. Just buy the dip. Just close your eyes, plug your nose, and buy the dip. Well, one of the problems with that kind of thinking is we have to be able to endure the tremendous whipsaws that are likely to occur in this market. When you get an emotional market like this, just remember anything that you buy is likely going to be subject to those big emotional whips that very few people can actually have the tenacity to just buy and hold it and sit through these ugly whips. So I'm going to suggest that one of the better things for a lot of folks to do is just stand aside today. Try not to get involved in this emotionally. Protect your capital and avoid that rushing in or that revenge trading thing that a lot of us will feel this morning, that we'll see some losses in our accounts. And virtually everyone's going to lose money today in some way, shape, or form. But just keep in mind that if we rush in, if we make poor emotional decisions, we can actually make the situation much, much worse. Remember, the reason this is happening is because We have extended this market substantially. We were running up and ignoring the potential risks in this market. And we may see an adding to these risks as we go forward. If these numbers continue to expand out over the next few days, there certainly is nothing suggesting that we couldn't go even lower. So be careful to avoid that revenge trade or that idea that buying the dip is the wisest thing in the world. This may continue to gap on lower. We don't know. It's a very emotional reaction. So let's take a look at what we have here this morning. We do have some price support in this chart right through this area. I need to draw that just a little bit lower, as you can see, right through this area. And you can see we're down here testing that level of support. I suspect with this big dramatic move down, we'll probably get some kind of bounce. But just keep in mind, those bounces could be several hundred points and swing each direction. It's going to be very, very challenging for even the most experienced traders, and very dangerous even for the most experienced traders to try and sort through that making money. So just be really, really careful. Now, if we happen to fail down through that level, just keep in mind, this is one of those days where you might be surprised to see where we could sink 1,000 points, 1,500 points before it's over. So be really, really careful on how you approach this market today, and don't just try and jump right back in there. Let's take a look at the SPY. SPY, certainly much better condition than the Dow was by the close on Friday. Holding up better and holding up above some levels of support in this chart. But now we're gapping through those substantially, and as you can see, indicated to open down in here. Now, while there is a little bit of support in there, please keep in mind that we could easily sink into here or below pretty quickly as the market opens. Remember, what we're looking at right now is institutional reaction. We have yet to see the retail traders' reaction to this morning, and those panicked folks in 401ks and things like that, heavily invested in ETFs, that will be hitting stop losses this morning and dumping out of the market. So please keep in mind, this may not be the end of that push down, even though we're seeing the futures trying to push back up as earnings roll out this morning. Just keep in mind, there's going to be an awful lot of panic this morning, and folks will be running for the doors at the open. So keep that in mind. Let's take a look at the Qs. Now, Qs have been the strongest market or strongest index by far. But as you can see, they were substantially hit on Friday and now gapping quite a little bit lower here this morning as this panic starts to set in. Now, keep in mind, there's more support down in here. And if we get a bunch of selling, which we easily could, remember, we have a lot of NASDAQ stocks that are really looking very extended, as a matter of fact, almost parabolic in their moves. And when folks start heading for the exits and those stocks start pulling back, we could see a pretty dramatic decline in the NASDAQ as well. So just plan carefully and try not to panic. Just stay really focused on price action in these charts. Try to stay calm, because the last thing we want to do is make those emotionally charged decisions. And IWM this morning, certainly looking pretty unhealthy here this morning, gapping substantially lower and breaking down through price supports. Keep in mind that even though we're holding right in this area, we could easily sink back below this level and into this level pretty easily. So watch very, very closely today. Let's take a look at the VIX. Now, the VIX is going to get a dramatic reaction today. And it could be, well, just that panic setting in. And now I would expect really, really fast price action here. I would expect tremendous whipsaws. So be very careful here. But this is where we really start to put on some panic. holding this downtrend as support and breaking above this level right in here, we could quickly and easily be clear up here this morning. Boom. But keep in mind, we're going to see some big swings in that and just realize that we could still go higher. So even though we could gap all the way up into here and move all the way up in here, please understand, true panic gets tremendously bearish. And so that these levels up here could easily be what we see before this is over. So let's just try to stay calm and don't rush into trades. Notice these high peaks. And remember, this was just 2018 when this occurred, and this is the beginning of 2019. So we could easily see peaks like that occur as this panic unfolds. This may not be the last of this panic move. This may be just the beginning. So think about that and think about how you want to approach that the day. Just be very, very careful. Do not revenge trade this. Let's take a look at T2122. Now, T2122 is going to help us out maybe here a little bit today. And that is the sense that we are going to sink down here into a short-term oversold condition very, very quickly. That would really tell us that we could get some kind of reactionary bounce. Now, if we get that reactionary bounce and we happen to hold supports, we could get that lift to come back up for a period of time, possibly, as long as the news doesn't continue to show us this virus is continuing to expand. And that would be my worry, that we gap down and feel like this is, it can't go any lower than this, and then wake up tomorrow and find out that, whoops, yes, it can go substantially lower if this virus continues to add those worrisome numbers to the market. So watch that really closely. Try not to be betting your money on so many unknowns here in the market. So T2122 could help us. It could also just be that false sense of hope as this virus continues to spread out. Let's take a look at T2101. Now, the absolute breadth of the market was giving us this warning for some time. And one of the reasons I kept echoing over and over and over to just be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful. Don't overtrade, be careful. And I know it got monotonous there for a while, but hopefully you are beginning to see that those warnings were justified. Now this morning, we're likely to see this sink substantially as well, as a lot of folks will be running for the doors. So just keep in mind that there may be an awful lot of fluctuation going on in the market, and it's going to be very, very difficult to trade for a while because there's going to be tremendous volatility. As option traders, we're likely to see massively wide bid-ask spreads, hugely increasing implied volatility, making those options very, very expensive. And that could, that high implied volatility could collapse also very quickly, making it so you could even pick the right direction and still lose money with that volatility collapse. So be wise about how you trade today, and realize that even very, very experienced traders will find today a dangerous place to be and a very difficult market to trade in. Let's take a look at the economic calendar today, because we do have a few things that we want to consider. Not so much today on the economic calendar, but a few things that we'll want to think about for the rest of the week. And as you can see here on our, well, for Pete's sake, keeps picking up my other window here. Apologize for that. As you can see, today we really don't have a whole lot on here to move the market around. We do have a Fed speaker at 3, but that's probably not going to move us around at all. Everyone's going to be focused on this virus reaction. And as you can see, over the course of the week, we have some pretty important numbers: consumer confidence, new home sales, durable goods, GDP. These are going to be really interesting. GDP will be really interesting because of the virus impacts, to see if those numbers are starting to trickle in against that number. So just keep in mind, we have quite a few of those over the course of the week to pay attention to. We also have a really, really big week of earnings reports that could help us or hurt us as we move forward this week. Today, over 130 companies reporting. We have nearly 200 on Tuesday, over 250 on Wednesday, and over 300 reports on Thursday. So keep in mind, lots of earnings reports that could provide just additional volatility to the market as we try to come to grip with all what all this means this virus outbreak. So just keep in mind, there could be an awful lot of whipping around, an awful lot of volatility, and very, very challenging price action conditions to try to navigate. Let's take a look at some of the stocks that are reporting here this morning, and some of the notables. AWR reporting today. Just a wide bid-ask spread right now. No report on that one yet. CTB, Cooper Tires, reporting today. Looks like they have not reported. DDS got a little Dillard's report. They're still really wide bid-ask spreads, waiting for that report. HTZ, Hertz Global, reporting this morning. Looks like it's gapping just a little bit lower. HPQ. Reporting today. We'll want to take note of that. Looks like it's gapping a little bit lower here this morning. INTU gapping lower this morning. That's not helping us at all. Doggone it. KTOS gapping lower this morning after its report. OKE gapping substantially lower after its report this morning. Pan W gapping down here this morning. So we just have lots and lots of gaps. And right now, they're looking to the downside. Shake Shack holding up pretty well, at least so far this morning. So as we move throughout the day and these earnings reports continue to roll in, we could see substantial volatility. But the focus is going to be on this panic right now and what that actually means. How many folks start running for the door? So we'll want to watch this pretty darn closely. Now with that, let's take a look at some stocks that could be setting up. But before we do that, hey, I want to ask you guys for a favor. I know on a day like today, it's kind of, come on, ask me for a favor on today. if you could click that subscribe button on YouTube. Hopefully you're finding value in these videos. And I know that sometimes it just seems like, man, that Campbell guy, he just kept warning and warning and warning and warning, and we kept going up and up and up. But I think that warning has been justified now, and hopefully you're beginning to see the importance of removing that emotion and just really focusing in on the price action of the chart and how important price is to your trading. And if you have found that to be helpful, if you guys would do me a favor and click that thumbs up button and also leave a brief comment, that helps us an awful lot continuing to grow this channel. Now, I got to tell you guys, when it comes to talking about stocks today, there are places where you might want to look, but I got to tell you, today is going to be one of those very, very dangerous days. And even though there are a lot of stocks that are holding up well that you should have on your watch list, I'm going to tell you that trading today is probably going to be just an extremely dangerous thing to do. So I'll point out a few stocks here, but just make note that you're going to have to be extremely careful. And I personally will be standing aside. I have some short trades on, and I will likely be taking some profits on those this morning. I've got some other long trades on, very few though, some long trades on that I will probably see tripping stop losses, or I may be exiting those early, but to avoid any additional risk. But just be really, really careful here. So Coca-Cola holding up really well, and on Friday powered on through. This is one of those defensive sector stocks. Defensive sector stocks have held up really, really well ahead this in this panic. And you can see good, strong trend here in Coca-Cola. Tried to move up, and even though it's gapping down this morning, it's still holding into that price support. Let's watch stocks like that, defensive sector stocks, carefully. Another place you could look for a little bit of relative safety is in utilities. Utilities have been tremendously strong, as you can see, and you could break into some utilities to maybe look for a little bit of comfort or security. You know, stocks like Hershey, big old conservative stocks that are probably going to be around forever and a day. They're boring, but they pay a dividend yield, and we're seeing folks hold into those looking for that safety. So things like that you might want to be keeping an eye on. Another stock that's in that sector, Monster Beverage. Beautiful trend, holding up well, staying strong. Really wide bid-ask spread this morning. Look at how the market makers are protecting themselves with these bid-ask spreads, really wide. And keep in mind, this is going to report on the 27th, so anything is possible in here. Good patterns coming out of bottoms like Shake Shack. Shake Shack coming up out of this bottom, holding up very well. Let me show you my drawings on this chart. Moving up nicely in this trend. We moved up, pulled back, and had a little hammer here on Friday. That requires a follow through, and unfortunately, with this little push down here in the market, we may not get that follow through today. But if it holds in this area of support, there's still that opportunity. Stocks like that can go up. So keep in mind, we're going to always need food. We're going to always need those basic essentials, and people will be moving toward those things, those defensive sector stocks, those consumer staples, to protect themselves. So with that, everyone, I want to wish you all. Oh, by the way, I should have mentioned gold. Gold, silver is a place where folks have been running for a while for safety. What I will tell you is this is now a parabolic move. I would be careful chasing that. Bonds will be another place for relative safety, and you can see we've been rallying this up sharply. Gold, bonds, silver, things like that will be some of those protective areas to kind of look for some help. For a lot of traders, the better thing to do for the next day or so is maybe just stand aside, protect your capital, let this settle out, see how this does settle out, and then we can make some decisions from there, rather than basing our decision on panic. Everyone, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you a great day of profits if you happen to be short this morning. Everyone, take care of yourselves, and we'll see you right back here bright and early Tuesday morning. Have a good one.